are all Christians and therefore should be united. Of course, in practice, it doesn't quite go that way. Just think Protestants and Catholics. But the idea was always there, in the background. So there is that ideology there, if you will. I already spoke a lot about economic integration as well. The fact that you become interdependent, an entry into the EU makes you even more interdependent. And why is that a good thing? Well, it means usually more jobs, higher growth, higher per capita income for everybody. So that economically, and this is actually a proven thing. It has been heavily researched in economics. What are the effects of membership for the economy? And it's a very positive development generally. Another thing I just mentioned is the billions of Brussels. This is this thinking that when we become a member, we get all a few million euros from the budget, we are getting rich, we buy ourselves a BMW and life is great. Now, this is all paid for by Brussels. A wonderful life. It would be nice actually if that would be the case. Of course it doesn't work that way. You can forget that right away actually. No country is ever going to get rich through the EU budget. Forget it. It's not going to happen. Why is that? First of all, the budget is actually relatively small compared to also to the GDP, to the what a country annually produces, gross domestic product. You can only get a small part of the gross domestic product as through the EU budget, and in net terms, it's quite limited. Second of all, the budget. It's less than 1% of the gross domestic product of the European Union. That budget has to be in balance. So what comes in is exactly the same as what goes out. So there's not going to be, the only thing it does is it redistributes money a bit. That's all. It's going to make a difference at the margin. Some regions will develop a bit faster because of that aid. I mean, I'm not saying it doesn't have any effect. It does have an effect, but it's limited. It's politically very important. The symbolism is very important. You feel good if you get money from the EU, and you feel a bit less good if you have to pay in. So there's a symbolism there. And politicians always get endlessly upset about the EU budget, and then they forget that their national budgets are about 45 times as large, or 100 times as large, as what they pay into the EU budget. But that's then, of course, a different story. So, that budget is more of a political than an economic argument to enter. But the argument to enter is, well, you become part of a larger market, it forces you to cooperate, it forces you into the cold winds of competition. You can no longer help your friends with nice state aids and protect your products of your economic friends or political friends who have a nice factory and they don't want the competition. That is just going to stop from now on. Which is good for consumers, which is good for employers, which is good for employment. Yeah, it's economically over.